Hey everybody, this is Guru Francis, Big Boy Scribador, and today's another episode of Bayani Talk. Hey everybody, this is Guru Francis, Big Boy Scribador, and today's another episode of Bayani Talk, and today is going to be part two of what happened at the tournament where the referee lost control. I'm going to re-show the clip again, and again, viewer's discretion is advised. Hi everybody, this is Guru Francis. So let's get right into this. So again, you know, we talked about what the referee did and what the referee should have done and what the referee, failed to do. But now let's talk about the rest of the tournament. What was even more shocking is that even though I mentioned in the first video, I didn't know this happened until the following day when I was reviewing film footage. The tournament directors didn't know that this happened as well. And to me, that's very, you know, that's very red flag, because, you know, as I've been a tournament director before, it is my job to know exactly what's happening in my tournaments. And the mere fact that this happened and the referee was allowed to continue to be the referee for the rest of the day, that's really disconcerting. If I was there, I would have stopped the match. I would have called for the tournament directors right away to remove this person from being a referee. But they didn't know. So I understand that they didn't know. And of course, in fairness to the tournament directors, they had no idea that this referee was going to do that, right? They had no idea that this referee was going to do that. And honestly, 25 years of Filipino martial arts, I've never seen a referee hit a fighter or a competitor in the back of the head. I've never seen that. It is safe to assume that they had no idea that this person was going to do that. But the question is, how come there was nobody to tell that referee, you're done, right? So yes, at the moment, I don't think that there's anything anybody could have done, but there's a lot of things that people could have done afterwards, and yet they let this person continue to be a referee. And what's scary about that is that according to the tournament directors, only instructors are allowed to be judges and referee at the tournament. So based upon that requirement, it is safe to assume that now this fighter, this referee, was an instructor. And an instructor to lose control like that is extremely dangerous. Now, I'm a Filipino martial arts instructor, and yes, I get frustrated just like the next person. I get angry like the next person. I too have a temper. But once we decide to be a martial artist, or at the very least a martial arts instructor, we have taken an extra responsibility to use the skills that we have only as a last resort, only as a life and death situation. And in this particular case, that was nowhere near a life and death situation. And I've said this before, a tournament is never a life and death situation. It is just a competition. It's not worth somebody's life or health or safety, right? So what concerns me if this person was an instructor and yet he did that, I mean, that's very dangerous. Now, when I talked to the tournament directors about this, my question to them was, where was the safeguards to ensure that if something like this happened, why wasn't there other tournament directors to pull that referee out of there? Right? They let this referee continue to fight. Now, when I talked to the tournament directors, they told me that they talked to the referee and that he feels really, really bad about that. I'm sorry, but I don't think he does, because if he felt really, really bad about it, he should have told them that what he did. I think he waited for somebody to call him before he felt really bad about it. Now, I could be guessing here, but the mere fact that if he was really feeling bad about what he did, he should have pulled himself out of that match. But he didn't. He allowed himself to continue to be a referee throughout the rest of the day, even though he did what he did. And the mere fact that somebody had to call him first and ask him what happened and then he feels bad, I don't think that's really feeling bad. I think you just feel like you got caught, right? So now, I don't know this person. I don't know this person from Adam. I'm not saying he's a bad person. What I am saying is that, you know, if he really felt bad, he should have been the one to fess up and say, hey, I messed up. I'm so sorry. And just again, for, you know, full context, I did reach out to the tournament directors to kind of get their opinion and to get their side of the story, or at the very least tell us what they're going to do to make sure that this isn't going to happen again. And I hope that it never does happen again, because these are great guys. These are, you know, they're my friends. But I, you know, I had to post this because, one, even though I want to support every FMA event out there, it is only secondary to the mere, to the fact of my greater responsibility to ensure that every one of my students that attend these events are as safe as possible. And for them, for my student to almost have gotten hit by a referee, even though he was aiming at the other guy, is irrelevant. My fighter was in danger, right? And so I definitely was not, that was not cool with me. And in order for me to support any event, I have to have faith, and I have to have, no, not faith, I have to have trust that the tournament directors have done everything in their powers to make sure that this person, you know, or this situation doesn't happen again. Now, I am asking that this person never be a referee again, and I am asking that this person, you know, really looks inside of him and say, you know, what happened, and how, why did I cross the line, and how do I make sure that doesn't happen again? And I really hope that this person, the referee, really, you know, takes that to heart. Now, I might get some backlash on this video. I might get a lot of hate from this video, but keep in mind, I'm not the one that hit the fighter in the back of the head. I'm just the one reporting it. I'm just the one talking about it. I'm just the one that's putting out into the Filipino martial arts community so that we can discuss this, you know, and then, you know, come to some sort of understanding and ways that we can prevent this from happening again. I don't know, that's just my opinion. Do you guys agree? Comment down below. And, you know, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget that notification button so you're alerted to the next time a video drops. Until next time, my name is Guru Francis, Big Boy Screamador. Peace out, God bless, and keep swinging them sticks. GoPro, stop recording.